this love. I gave you everything you wanted, babe. You said you love me, I said I love you too. Even in the craziest times, when we thought we made love, I held you closely, you opened up your heart to me. Time after time we dealt with it. This time I know we'll see you through. You'll always be the one for me, baby, girl, I'm feeling you. Time after time we dealt with it. This time I know we'll see you through. You'll always be the one.
Now the delegate from the Philippines, Miss Lalaine Bennett.
Maligayang bati sa inyong lahat. Alam kong ang buong Pilipinas ay ngayon nasisiyahan sa gabing ito. As a child, I have always wanted to come to visit the native land of my grandfather, who was one of the first American teachers who came to help educate my people. Through this pageant, my dream has been fulfilled. America has helped the Philippines, taught us how to stand on our own two feet, and in 1946 gave us a most wonderful gift, the gift of freedom. For this, I, together with my people, will forever be grateful. Please accept our sincere thanks. United States of America, thank you.
The delegate from the Philippines. From the Philippines, Mirna Panlilio.
The Philippines, Luis Vale O'Reilly. From South Africa.
Miss Philippines. Maria Clorinda Soriano from Quezon City, the capital of the Philippines. She's studying to be a nurse. She wants to live in the United States or Canada for a while and pick up on modern nursing techniques and then go back and work in your own country.
Mm-hmm.
In Quezon?
Luzon, yes.
In Luzon. Oh, I have Quezon. Luzon it's pronounced. You speak what languages?
English, Filipino, and a little Spanish.
How do you say Miss Universe in the Philippines? This was interesting because I was talking to her about it. There is no direct translation, is there?
Yes, there is no literal translation, but we call her Pinakamagandang Dilag sa Buong Daigdig.
And what does that mean?
Miss Universe.
Oh, all right. Very good. And congratulations to you, Miss Philippines. Miss Philippines.
Maria Clorinda Soriano. She's 5'6" tall and weighs 120 pounds. She has black hair and black eyes. She's 20 years old.
Good evening. My name is Sharina Zaragoza. I'm from Manila.
Philippines.
Good evening. My name is Gloria Diaz, and I'm from Manila.
Next, Miss Philippines. And I think there are people here who will be...
Miss Philippines is Gloria Diaz. She's a student taking a business course, and she has two brothers and nine sisters. My, that's a big family.
Yes, it is.
Is it fun having so many brothers and sisters?
It really doesn't make a difference. I mean, it's just like a small family, I think.
How can it be like a small family when there's so many of you?
Well, everybody goes on their own way. They just come back during lunch, dinner, and breakfast.
You're just there at mealtime.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, Gloria. Our interview is planned. Here you are on television with this big audience. Let's see. Can you name your nine brothers and two sisters, or nine sisters and two brothers?
Alphabetically, or according to rank?
I think all mixed up. Go ahead.
Joselito, Fenty, Ramon, Ruby, Patsy, Coroy, Gory, Aurora, Bibi, Georgie, Benji, Rio.
Very good, but when you get home, apologize to Aurora, won't you? You missed that one for a moment. Thank you, Miss Philippines.
Miss Philippines. In the next day or so, a man will land on the moon. If a man from the moon landed in your hometown, what would you do to entertain him?
Oh, it's the same thing I do. I think if he's been in the moon for so long, I think when he comes over, he wants to change, I guess.
Very good. Very good, Miss Willoughby. The first runner-up is Miss Finland, Miss Philippines, is Miss Universe of 1969. We'll put your arm right back here. Coming up, here's the sash that you'll be wearing for the next year, Miss Universe 1959. And Miss Philippines, now Miss Universe, will you please step out on the ramp in your traditional walk?
Miss Philippines.
My name is Simonette de los Reyes, and I come from Pasay City.
Miss Philippines, voted Miss Photogenic.
I'm Vida Goya from the city of Manila, Philippines.
Miss Philippines.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Army Barbara Crespo, and I come from Manila, Philippines.
Miss Philippines. Two more names to go. One of those names is Miss Philippines. And now, the Miss Philippines, and your name is?
Army Barbara Crespo.
And Army, you're a student, and you're studying what?
Mass communication.
And what would you like to do?
I would like to work in a television or a radio company.
Good for you. Now, Army, on your questionnaire, you said that astrology was your hobby.
That's right.
Can you just look at a person sometimes and tell their sign? Try it with me. Now, you and I have been together here this week working. What sign do you think I was born under?
Well, the way I look at you, I think you belong to the sign of Libra.
Libra? Why Libra?
Because they are said to be good speakers and well-balanced persons.
In other words, since I'm not an unbalanced person, I'm under Libra, huh?
That's right.
No, you're wrong. I'm a Sagittarian.
Oh, just the same as I do.
Are you a Sagittarian?
That's right.
Sagittarians, I understand, are... What you tell me.
They are big-hearted people.
Let's not go any further. That's fine, Miss Philippines. Thank you. Miss Philippines.
Army Barbara Crespo. She's from Manila. She's 5 feet, 5 and a half, and she's tall and weighs 110 pounds. She has black hair and dark brown eyes, and she's 18 years old.
Miss Philippines.
Voted most photogenic in the pageant.
Magandang gabi. Ako po si Margarito Moran, taga Maynila.
Miss Philippines. The fourth name on the list is Miss Philippines. And now, Miss Philippines does know English, and your name is?
Margarita Moran.
And what would you like to do, Margarita?
Later?
Yes, as a job.
I'd like to be a banker.
A banker? Why a banker?
Well, first, I'd like to follow my father's footsteps because he's a banker. And besides that, I'm taking up a course in business administration, which is courses in banking and finance. And I like counting money.
You like counting money? What would you do with the $10,000 if you win in the Miss Universe pageant?
I'd invest it. Probably I'll build up a hotel.
A hotel?
Yes, and I'll run a business, and my sister will manage it because she's taking up business hotel management in school.
You know, I think I've made a discovery. This girl could be the Onassis of the Philippines before she's through. Thank you very much, Miss Philippines. Yes.
Miss Philippines.
Maria Margarita Moran. She has dark brown hair and dark brown eyes. 5 feet 6 inches tall and weighs 116 pounds. 19 years old.
Miss Philippines. Miss Israel. Miss Philippines. The second girl is a girl who's been one of your favorites all evening long. She is Miss Philippines. The next
question
lady
is for you. Your question is, let's make believe that all of a sudden, this is a perfect question for her. Let's make believe that all of a sudden you had $1 million. What's the first thing you would buy, and why would you buy
it? A house and lot. Because it's the most expensive thing, and I can't afford it. So if I had $1 million, I'll buy a house and lot and live by myself and other people, of course.
Thank you very much, Miss Philippines. First runner-up is Miss USA. Miss Philippines is Miss Universe. Of 1973. There she is.
We, the young women of the universe, believe people everywhere are seeking peace, tolerance, and mutual understanding. We pledge to spread this message in every way we can, wherever we go.